Notice that I have the daisy positioned perpendicular to the table, and I've already created an incision using a scalpel blade in the skin portion of the daisy. Just to review, this is the skin portion of the daisy, and of course inside the daisy is the intestinal portion, which we'll leave tucked inside. I'm going to be demonstrating the near-far, far-near suture pattern, which is a tension-relieving suture pattern that's used primarily under conditions of tension on the skin. And so you will be performing this pattern on the skin portion of the daisy. Notice that I have the needle holder positioned in the center of the needle, securely clamped in position. I'm properly using the thumb forceps as well. And I'm going to grasp the near portion of the skin. Okay, this is the near bite on the near side. This is the far, meaning far from the incision, on the far side of the incision. Reset. Now I'm going to pull through the suture material so I don't waste a lot of suture. Now this third bite is far from the edge. And the fourth bite is near the edge. Now I've taken care this time to make sure that both arms of my suture are on the same side, so I don't cross the suture, although it's probably not that much of a worry. I want to tie straight across the incision. Now you can see how the suture pattern actually takes up tension very nicely. And so this is performing a square knot. You can see that the tension is not taken up very well with just a simple square knot. Now I'm using polydioxinone 910, which is commonly known as Vicryl suture. It's number one in size. So in order to get this tied properly, I'm going to use a surgeon's knot comprised of a surgeon's throw followed by a simple throw. And you can see that that takes up the tension and is tied properly with the proper tension on the suture ends.